Hi all, Dr. Clark here, and this series of lectures is going over general biology lab materials and lab lessons, okay? Procedures, each lab in the general biology lab manual, I'm going to go through, okay? Analyze and highlight some of the information, give you some examples of how it's completed, and then for some of you, this might be a really good review on, you know, what were the procedures and why were they done, okay? For others who are taking this online, the procedures are going to be used for you to then analyze the questions, write the answers to the questions, and analyze the material from that lab. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. A lot of the first pages of the lab manual are for students that are coming to campus and are live. And you can see here, there's just some general information about me as an author, acknowledgments about all the individuals that helped write this lab manual or helped at least give me feedback on this lab manual, etc. Okay. This is kind of the owner page. If you bought the book, I highly suggest filling it out with your lab group's information, our lab members' information, and then, you know, a contact for them. Because a lot of the labs in this series are going to be done as a group, okay? So another piece is the safety agreement that I have students sign. And that's just kind of a peace of mind for me. If you're in my lab and you get hurt, okay, by signing this, you are acknowledging not only that I went over safety protocol, okay, but I went over, you know, proper attire, appropriate behavior, you know, where the fire extinguishers are, this kind of stuff, if you're coming to live class. And if you're not taking this live and it's all virtual, then really there's no safety agreement, okay, unless, you know, you're trying these at home. If you're trying some of these labs at home, you know, be careful, okay? Because some of them, there are some pieces that you could get cut, you could get burned, and those kind of things, all right? Table of contents, okay, and then general instructions. The general instructions is really about kind of how the laboratory system is working in general biology, okay? Some of the key components like group work, like I said before, most of the labs will be done as a group, okay? And that's really because science in today's society is done by multiple individuals. You'll rarely see someone publish information on their own, okay? And that's because they're is so many aspects of science, okay? To get a high tier publication today, you really have to dive into a lot of different fields, and really no one's an expert in every field, and it's better to have someone who is an expert in that field help out on a research project than to try to learn that field also, okay? No one has that kind of time. Although there will be some individuals that publish alone still today, but for the most part, people are publishing with other people, okay? Apart from that, just group work in general is extremely important, okay? The social part of it, the social skills, okay? How to deal with time management and these kind of pieces are very important when it comes to group work. And no matter really what job you're going into, whether you're going to be a nurse or a doctor or a pharmacist, or, you know, maybe you're going into dental hygiene, whatever it is, if you're going into the health sciences, okay, you're going to work with other people. Even if you're going to work in the natural resources pieces and you're going to go and be a forest manager or wildlife manager, or game warden, okay, those pieces, you're still working with people, okay? And so group work is extremely important, okay? And that's also sharing ideas, okay? So if you've done a piece of the work and someone else didn't, okay, sharing the results from that work is very important, okay? When it comes to lab reports, We're going to go over lab reports. I have the first lab is really how to write a lab report, but lab reports are written in general biology. Lab reports are written as if you're going to submit it to a scientific journal. You're going to have all the pieces. It's not little teeny pieces of information. Now, maybe you're writing the intro, you know, this week, and then the methods next week, and et cetera. Okay, but the whole paper is what we're after. We're after the entire thing flowing together, working together, and being a solid piece of writing. And we'll come back to this when I talk about lab number one, writing lab reports. All right, so jumping into that, or jumping out of lab reports and into exams, for this lab, we have some major exams in the sense of skills exams. These are skills that we as professors in biology believe that students coming out of biology should have the capability of doing. One is proper use of microscope, and this is a big one. Okay? In general biology, we teach microscope skills. Okay? We teach how to clean, focus, okay? When to use a certain type of microscope and another microscope, how to make slides, how to dispose of material that's on slides, et cetera, et cetera. And these skills are important for students to learn coming out of general biology. Okay? Number two is all scientists, whether you're a biologist, a chemist, a physicist, okay, should be well-versed in statistical analysis. Okay? And so we start off, you know, with Gen Bio, you know, we're starting off basic statistics, okay, and working our way up into a little more complex statistics. But the point is to be able to collect data, analyze data, and present data, okay? A very big piece of general biology lab, okay? And number three, labeling and drawing pictures. Now, most biology students are not art majors, right? And they're probably poor artists. But that being said, it's not necessarily about the drawing, but it's more about the labeling, okay? Proper labels on everything, whether that be proper labels on, you know, a sketch that you made of a cell or a sketch of a dissection, okay? All the way to being able to label figures and graphs and tables, okay? And all the labeling that goes into science is where the true information is. Now, if you're a good artist and you're very good at sketching things, that's a bonus, okay? But if you can do mediocre sketches and excellent labels, you'll do fine in a general biology exam when it comes to sketching and labeling. And the final piece is writing scientifically. Okay? Most individuals go their entire life, or at least first 18 years, maybe a little less than that, you probably learn how to write things in first grade. So maybe they go for 12 years of their life learning how to write so people enjoy reading it, okay? And people will keep reading it. So they write mainly for flow and sometimes humor and whatnot, but scientists, and often I hear this from students, that scientific writing is boring. And I don't want to say it's boring, because as a scientist, I read it a lot and I don't find it boring. But what I find scientific writing, how it differs from non-scientific writing, is scientific writing is to the point. Okay? There's not a lot of fluff. The data is presented, the facts are presented, okay? And then you move on to more data and more facts. Okay? And you're not going into a great detail and fluffing things up so people enjoy reading it, but instead you're presenting a lot of material, a lot of data, a lot of analysis, okay, a lot of methods in a kind of linear form so that people will read through it, get the gist, and they're not really reading it for enjoyment, not too much at least. They're reading it to gain knowledge on a subject material and either, you know, advance that subject material or, you know, use that information to advance a different subject material. And we'll come back to this, okay? But so that skills exam is really looking at those four main skills. Okay? And you can see here, I have information about proper use of microscope, how that's going to work, how the exam portion works, data analysis, okay, drawing and labeling, written description, okay. And then like most lab courses, there is a lab practical piece, okay, and this would be a very large cumulative exam at the end of the semester that's over all the labs or has the potential to be over all the labs that you covered within the semester. And this piece is done typically by most scientists. It's done in an old-fashioned, you know, move station to station way. Even if you're taking this virtually, it's still going to be moving from question to question with, you know, a certain amount of time to answer each one of those questions. Okay. So that really brings me to lab number one, okay, writing lab reports.